Welcome back. Scientists are set to learn more about volcanoes in the southern Lesser Antilles through recent installation of a temporary network of seismic instruments in St. Vincent and the Grenadines, which will bolster earthquake monitoring capacity and facilitate closer study of the structure of volcanoes. Seismic recording stations have been installed in Union Island, Canawon, Mustique, Bekwe, and St. Vincent. The installation was part of the volatiles in the Lesser Antilles Viola project, which seeks to provide a better understanding of earthquakes and volcanic activity in the southern Lesser Antilles. As part of this project, instruments will also be deployed in St. Vincent, St. Lucia, and Grenada. Additional studies on the development of volcanism in this region are planned for May 2017. Subduction zones where tectonic plates run into each other, forcing the heavier plate beneath the lighter one, are known for the potential to generate large earthquakes, tsunamis, and explosive volcanism. The islands of the Eastern Caribbean or Lesser Antilles were formed in one of these subduction zones. This subduction zone has produced large earthquakes in the historic past, and explosive volcanism has devastated large sections of Montserrat in 1995. The Viola project is funded by the National Environment Research Council, the NERC, and is a collaborative effort between several universities and research institutions based in the United Kingdom and Europe in partnership with the University of the West Indies Seismic Research Center and supported in St. Vincent and the Grenadines by the National Emergency Management Organization, NEMO. Senator Julian Francis, who was recently re-elected as General Secretary of the Unity Labour Party, ULP, for the 23rd consecutive year, said in Parliament yesterday that the public service must vote to keep the Democratic Party out of power. Francis said the public servants must be wary of the NDP, as that party will reduce the public service if they were ever to win general elections. "Beware of those who want to come and drain the swamp," said Francis, borrowing from the term used by President Donald Trump during the last U.S. election campaign. In response, Daniel Cummings of the NDP said that this party, or his party, has no such plans. The World Pediatric Project has commenced its missions for 2017, and specialists are expected to see 50 children from the region for its general surgery mission, which includes follow-up cases. After leaving the land of the Blessed St. Vincent, the team traveled to Grenada. GBN spoke to the Chief Medical Officer at the Ministry of Health about Grenada's participation in the program.
And we've been sending children between the ages of 0 and 18 to St. Vincent to do corrective interventions in several areas, including general surgery, pediatrics, neurology, urology.
With the assistance from donor organizations, the most recent from the Eastern Caribbean Group of Companies of $50,000, WPP spends over $30 million carrying out surgeries on children. Dr. Mitchell said they are grateful for the work of the project.
These areas, high-end surgery that, cannot be done here. And so we've benefited to the tune of millions of dollars, actually, in this project. And we hope that the project could continue because, of course, you know, there's always a financial part to it. But thus far, every year, we, 40, 50 kids are seen in clinics. And we have an average 35 to 45 persons going to St. Vincent for one intervention or the other. And, in that period, we have persons whose surgeries cannot be undertaken in St. Vincent who would be sort of like referred to centers in the U.S., collaborating centers with the World Pediatric Project. So for us, it has been a good project.
According to the World Pediatric Project, equipment valued at $1.2 million were installed recently at the Milton Memorial Hospital in St. Vincent. Volunteer pediatric surgical and diagnostic teams travel annually to the island in a variety of subspecialty areas. Children from surrounding islands travel for treatment by the visiting team.
Persons looking to travel from New York directly to St. Vincent on February 14th, when the Argyle International Airport AIA opens, are expected to be able to purchase tickets by today. Prime Minister Dr. Ralph Gonsalves, speaking on radio over the weekend, said that hopefully tickets for Caribbean Airlines and Dynamic Airlines flights out of JFK will soon go on sale. Tickets are currently on sale for February 14 flights out of Toronto to St. Vincent. As the commencement of operations at the Argyle International Airport AIA draws closer, booking details for yet another airline scheduled to fly into the airport have been released by the St. Vincent and the Grenadines Tourism Authority, the SVGTA. This morning, Tuesday, January 31st, the SVGTA announced that persons wishing to travel to the Caribbean via Caribbean Airlines, CAL from New York, can book through Brooklyn-based travel agent Early Travel. The CAL flight will depart from John F. Kennedy International Airport in New York on February 14th at 10:40 a.m. and land at the AIA at 4:24 p.m. the same day. The flight will then depart St. Vincent on February 21st at 5:40 p.m., arriving in New York at 9:30 p.m. Still with more airport news. As the AIA nears its official opening, it has a tremendous amount of visitors from all walks of life. Yesterday, Monday, 30th January, saw the tour of a group called the Returning Nationals, comprised of Vincentian nationals residing in the UK, Canada, and the United States, accompanied by the Governor General Sir Frederick Ballantyne yesterday. IKTV personnel Barbara Andrews spoke with the head of the group, Mrs. Nayoka Clowden, who gave her a synopsis of what the group is all about. The Returning Nationals is a fundraising group which started some 6 years ago with the intention of giving back to the Vincentian Society. So far, donations were made to a number of institutions, including the hospital. Some $15,000 derived from the fundraising activities, such as barbecues and raffles, were donated to the AIA. At the end of the tour yesterday, Mrs. Clowden remarked that she was well pleased with the facilities, which by far met and exceeded her expectations. During a radio discussion program on Sunday, which reviewed the Argyle International Airport project from the start to completion, it was reported that thousands of persons have been touring the international airport at Argyle over the past 2 weeks as preparations continue for the official opening of the facility on Tuesday, February 14th. Prime Minister Dr. Ralph Gonsalves said the Argyle International Airport holds tremendous promise for the country and commended the AIDC for its tremendous work on completing the airport. Dr. Gonsalves said an opportunity exists for St. Vincent and the Grenadines to become a transit hub for cruise ship passengers. The United States Agency for International Development, USAID Eastern and Southern Caribbean, ESC, has signed an agreement with the Caribbean Community Climate Change Center, the CCCCC, for the implementation of the Climate Change Adaptation Program, CCAP, in the Eastern and Southern Caribbean. The CCCC will visit St. Vincent on February 1st and 2nd, 2017. They will meet with key stakeholders on the first day, and on the second day, 2nd February 7, 2017, a wider consultation will be held at the NIS training room from 9 a.m. to 12 noon. The project aims to reduce risk to human and natural assets resulting from climate change vulnerability and will focus on strengthening and integrating change as climate change information use, innovative adaptation approaches and sustainable financing within the USAID ECC's coverage area, Antigua and Barbuda, Barbados and the Commonwealth of Dominica, Grenada, Guyana, St. Kitts and Nevis, St. Lucia, St. Vincent and the Grenadines, Suriname and Trinidad and Tobago. Following this commercial break, we bring you more local stories.